Hello, family, friends, and random people. I am Dimmy, and I wish you a wonderful day wherever in the world you might be. It's finally here, this documentary that I've been blabbing about for months, that people have been asking me about for months. It's finally finished. This thing has gone through so many problems. I've had equipment breaking down, software expiring, my computer crashed, but it's finally done. I finished it for you to see. Now, I'm actually right now on board the Voyager of the Seas. This is my second contract working on cruise ships. Behind me right now is the Royal Promenade. We're actually set up for Mardi Gras tonight for our Mardi Gras parade. The documentary you're about to see is gonna be on The Sovereign of the Seas, actually my first contract working on cruise ships. Now, I made this documentary for many different reasons. One of them was to just get some training in video for fun. I wanted to show my family and friends back home my experience here, but most importantly, I wanted to capture that experience forever for myself and for those who shared it with me. So, for all of you people from The Sovereign, here it is. For those of you who weren't there with me, I hope you enjoy it. And for anyone who hasn't worked on cruise ships, here is a glimpse into the life of those who work in paradise and vacation back home. Enjoy.
Ship life. It can be a lot of work at times, but also a whole lot of fun. Staff, youth staff, cast, and other departments, we all became one big fun-loving family. One great thing about our family was that we were close enough to have fun together off the ship, to explore life together and try new adventures. And ship life provides ample opportunities for adventure. And all that jazz.
Legs up now, come on. Take your hands off and look up.
Yay! Oh!
Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz.
It wasn't all about drinks and dancing. For much of the closer-knit family, work involved tending to the guests. Guest areas include the large dining rooms, the shopping area, the library with comfy couches, and even the casino. There's also the enormous entertainment lounges, the sports deck, the pool deck, and of course, the spacious staterooms. All of this in the interest of keeping the guests happy. Sail Away from Sovereign's home base of Port Canaveral, Florida, takes the crew into a completely different life. Ship life. Cabin inspections, corridor parties, and working at opposite ends of the day make for a very different existence. Crew members crowd the back deck, searching for signal strength and a fleeting link with those back home.
The ship's life is completely different from land's life because when you're here, you don't know sometimes which date we are, with which day we are next, with month sometimes. You get completely lost from the calendar, everything.
This compared to that, to working in a 9-to-5 job where you're working all the time and you're with people who are stressed all the time, it's totally different. I mean, here, when you're done, you can go lay out on the beach. You can get a floaty mat. You can go to the back deck and look out at the water, look at the stars, or it's just the whole atmosphere is beautiful and it's pretty low pressured. It's a pretty low pressure job.
The lounges, dining rooms, theaters, and shops, all guest areas, are only the stage where staff and crew perform. There is also the backstage world of the crew areas. Here to show you that world, Mr. Paul Wells. Under the boardwalk.
everybody. My name is Paul Wells. I work in the Viking Crown Lounge up there. Big round looking thing. And we're here today to take you on a little tour of our beautiful ship, the ship we like to call home. And there's a lot to see here on our beautiful ship. It's the gem of the Royal Caribbean line, as much of a gem as it could be, having been around for 14 years and sort of falling apart. And smells you wouldn't imagine. But we're going to take you around and show you all the wonderful behind-the-scenes aspects of the Sovereign of the Seas. All right, here we are in the I-95. You can see all the way down, runs the whole length of the ship. And, well, gee, it's about as exciting as it gets, I suppose. And, of course, we always keep in mind the 10-foot policy. If anybody passes within 10 feet of us, we say, hi, how are you, and my pleasure, and it's really nice to see you, and I hope you're having a great day, and hope that nobody shanks us or stabs us or anything like that, you know, because it is sort of a representation of the world here, and Lord knows it's a dangerous place to be, so sometimes the I-95 is a dangerous place to be, but it's where we have to travel, it's where we live, it's our beautiful ship that we love, that we call home. Hi, how you doing? Good to see you. My pleasure. Oh, move a little bit over here. We have somebody coming through, working, doing their job. How are you? Say hello to the camera.
All right.
All right. All right. Hello again. Here we are at the crew elevator area. These are the elevators that run up and down all along the up and down areas of the ship. And these are the elevators that usually drunken crew members use to escape security and any of their department heads. But come along with me. We're going to show you the laundry room right this way. Some clutter here for you to look at. Watertight door. And like I said, people doing their laundry. Here we are. We're on our little ship tour, guys. Showing everybody back home, all the folks, friends and family, the luxurious surroundings of the wonderful Sovereign of the Seas, the gem of the seven seas. And here we are. Which laundry, which dryers are working today?
More than two
today. It's a good day here. And unfortunately, you'd...
Working.
Oh, these two aren't working.
Almost 2 months.
So we have, what, 842 crew members, two dryers, and here's our washers. And I had the pleasure of ironing one shirt here the other night, and I was in ankle deep water. So it's, I don't know what to tell you. Sometimes instead of doing laundry, I just kind of want to kill myself.
Let me go on, like I blister in the sun. Let me go on, big hands, I know you're the one.
All right, here we are in the Chinese laundry, the real laundry on the ship. You don't want to go mess with that crew laundry, man. This is where the real stuff gets done. And as you can see, a lot of guys working hard. It's hot and steamy down here. Personally, I like it hot and steamy. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go interview Goo. Yeah, you heard me right. His name's Goo. And he's going to tell us a little bit about the Chinese laundry. So Goo, so tell me, I know you have a big operation here. You do a lot of laundry for crew and passengers. Tell me about, you know, tell me about how much laundry you do a day and how long you guys work.
Okay, 我们这边有每天有很多衣服要洗，包括客人的，还有crew有很多。前次我们自己做，现在都一般来讲，我们都是到crew mess这方面的隐私。从隐私方面对我们说没有什么问题啊。一般说我们船上安排呢还是蛮充足的。Oh,
that's amazing. Well, I've definitely learned some things here today, and it's good to be here. Say hello to Goo. You've met Goo. We're going to take a little walk around the Chinese laundry, and we'll see you in a bit. Well, this is kind of a bonus. I brought my clothes down here about 2 days ago, and I've been kind of waiting for them to get done, and I find that they're all done. So I just want to point out a few of my favorite items in my wardrobe collection. This is my blue gown, which I like a lot. It kind of brings out the color of my eyes, you know, and I just wear a little blue mascara, and it's I think, really shows off my inner beauty also, this blue one here. And this is kind of when I'm feeling like in a light mood, kind of like a Star Wars, Star Trooper kind of mood, you know, this one here. And when I really feel like doing something ornate, or I'm maybe performing a couple Prince tunes, you know, I go for this number. And sometimes, even if it's not Halloween, I'll wear this number. Yeah. right. We found the secret weapon here in the Chinese Laundry. I don't know where any cruise ship would be without this stuff. This stuff gets rid of all our problems. All right, here we are in the print room / VHS DVD rental. We like to multitask here at Royal Caribbean, and we have all kinds of movies. Really nice selection from the 80s, and we have some DVDs, and I don't watch these things too much because there's not enough skin in them, really. I mean, let's be honest, for me, I mean, it's just not what I'm into, you know, but I kind of like this one because it's Oscar-nominated actresses, and Angelina Jolie shows her boobies, and this is a pretty good one, and, you know, Demi Moore gets kind of butch, and she shows her boobies, so that's kind of nice. And see Scream 3. That was pretty good. Jenny McCarthy was in this, and I'm not sure if she showed her boobies or not, but I just imagine that she did, so it's enough for me. I can't control my fingers, I can't control my brain, oh no. All right, here we are in our crew day room, which is really commonly known to us as the internet room. This is where we all come, use our internet, and if you're like me, last week I'm in the middle of a 45-minute email, and it completely shut off, and I lost the whole goddamn thing. Can I cuss on this thing? All right, because I like to cuss a lot. And that's basically it, internet. It's relatively cheap for those of us out on the sea. And this is the day room here. This is the ping pong table. Personally, in 6 months, I've never seen one person play ping pong, to mention two. There's the pool table. There are balls. Balls are important. And I've never seen anybody play pool here. But it's a nice day room. There's probably the Poseidon Adventure or something like that on TV. Maybe that's the reason nobody wants to hang out in here. To be reminded that this ship could go down any time because it's falling apart because it's 14 years old. All right. All right, here we are at the front of the ship, one of my favorite spots on the ship, front of the ship, deck 7. And it's okay during the day. It's real nice to see the front of the ship, and you see the beautiful ocean and Nassau, Bahamas, and wherever we're at. But at night, it's absolutely pitch black out here because the bridge needs night vision so that they can navigate. And at night, if anybody's coming around the corners here and they're coming out to the front, it is pitch black, so you can't see a doggone thing out here. So let me tell you, if you bring a loved one out here, nothing is off limits. It's a really nice place to be. I'm going off the rails on a crazy train. I'm going off the rails on a crazy train. All right, here we are in the crew mess, and this is a place that, well, let's just say it brings out a lot of opinions. And this is where we eat all of our food, obviously, most of us. And we have a wide array of beverages. And come with me for a minute, and we'll have a look around, see what we have available today. As usual, it's a pretty wide selection of food. We have margarine and butter and juice. And here's some milk. And today, I think the main meal on the menu is bacon. Pretty nutritious. And hot water, and here we have some small bowls in water. And this is one of my favorite bread buns. Mm-hmm. And here we have some salad dressing. Okay, just to be fair, the food really isn't out yet, just in case you've never been on a cruise ship and you didn't know. But those of you who've been on a cruise ship know what delicious and succulent fare we have in here. And I'm being a little sarcastic, but personally, there's way more food in here than I ever have in my own kitchen. So I'm pretty happy. And the way I see it, a lot of people come on the ship and gain some weight. So who knows? Who's to say? How's the workout? Well, here we are in the crew gym, and this is where all the crew gets to come and work out. We got free weights in here and a bunch of different machines. I like it a lot. That's why I'm so buff. And we get to hear all kinds of different music in here. You get to hear music from the Caribbean, Indian music, Yugoslavian music, all kinds of different kind of music in here. And it just blares right out of that speaker over there. And we have a good time. Look at this guy. He's buff. Check him out. When that guy got to the ship, he weighed 114 pounds. I'm standing in the crew bar, and this is where the crew bartender stands, actually, and pours all the drinks for the crew. And this is where people come to unwind and hang out and buy drinks that are even cheaper than the 50% off that we get upstairs in the normal guest bars. So a lot of people get pretty loose and pretty happy in this place. Here we are on the back deck of the Sovereign of the Seas. We're in beautiful Nassau, Bahamas today. And this is the party central area of the ship for the crew. This is where everybody comes after their shift and hangs out. At night, it's usually going off up here. Some people are usually sitting at all these tables and partying and getting real happy. And when we have crew parties, official crew parties, then it really goes off here. We got decorations and music and sometimes boobies. And this is one of the only open deck, back deck crew areas that Royal Caribbean has in their fleet. So it's pretty cool. And so kind of, we're known as a party ship. We have kind of a nice, intimate little crew, and we have fun with each other. We have a good time. So this is it. This is the happening back deck. Yeah. All right, well, that's been my part of our little tour here, and it's been fun walking around the ship and checking everything out. And now it's time for me to do what I usually do on the ship, which is take long naps. And thought you'd we'd show you a little bit about some of the rooms and what people can do with them on the ship. And this is Steve Hathaway's room. He's a shore excursion manager here on the ship, and I think, without a doubt, it is the most hip room on the ship. He's got it totally decorated. He's completely made everything in here, and it's the exact polar opposite of my room, which is pretty much a dump. All right, that's where the dive manager lives. That's where Khaled Ali lives. And this is where I live, right here. This is my room. See, that's me, Paul Wells. It says I'm a musician. Isn't that crazy? They could see me now. So I'm going to go ahead and take a long, long nap. And then maybe sometime later, I'll see you up in the Viking Crown Lounge.
Now that you've seen most areas of the ship, you're likely wondering where the crew sleeps. One of my fellow crew staff members provides answers with a short Sovereign Cribs tour.
Hi, my name's Katie. I am Demi's neighbor here on board, and I am crew staff. And you know what? Today, I am going to take you around all the cabins, because this is Sovereign of the Seas Cribs. So this is my crib. I've lived here from August the 20th. I've had two roommates. First one was Kylie, second one Layla. She is also crew staff. I live next door to Semi and Steps. And I also live next to Gillian and Fiona. Their crib is there. And this is my crib. So I've lived here from August the 20th, so a few months. We've, you know, done a few little special things to it. This is basically what the state of my flat is constantly. Never can find anything. General disorganisation. And this is it. This is my bed right here. Bottom bunk. That is the bed to have. Abercrombie and Fitch. Lots of shopping today. Very nice. So here I am at Semi's and Steps cabin. This is next door to mine. Let's see if they're in. Now this is known as, it's quite a palace. It's very tidy. He's in. Hey, Steps. Come on in. Let's see this little... Hi, Steps. How are you doing
today?
Oh, pretty good.
So, tell me, how long have you been living here?
I like Rich.
How long have you been living here, Steps?
3 months now.
3 months. And enjoy living in this crib?
That Demi snores, though. I'm glad he's got a girlfriend now and he doesn't sleep here that way. I have an enjoyable rest.
Do you rest, though?
No.
Or is this the bed of love?
That's the love bed.
That is the love bed. It's the sweet loving bed.
Mm.
So, what's your favorite thing about your crib?
Demi not being here.
What else?
I also like, what's your, Demi, come here. What's your booze cabinet?
Oh, nice. What do we have there? We have lots of...
vodka, and then we have more vodka.
Do you have any other sort of part to your crib?
Yes, my ball.
Okay.
I'm going to show this, and our plants. Beautiful plants.
Yeah.
It's our plants. Our collage at the wall. It's our collage.
Very nice. Very nice. So here I am at Denise's and Gail's cabanes. This is actually known as the Taj Mahal on board. Do you know what? This is why. Let's see if they're in. Youth staff actually sleep a lot, so they may be in bed, shouldn't be. Oh, were you sleeping? I'm sorry. Can we just, we're just going to go a quick tour of your crib, Denise. Is that okay? Everybody, this is Denise. She's part of your youth staff on board. How are you doing?
Good morning.
No, not good morning, Denise. Good evening. It's 6 o'clock.
Good evening.
So we're going to come in. This is the Taj Mahal, everybody. And do you know why it's called the Taj? Well, as you can see, I have done more than 5 steps. Steps. So, Denise, how long have you been living here, and who do you share with?
I've been here for 5 months. Mm-hmm. My first roommate was Diamond Dora, and I was on the top then, and now I'm on the bottom.
The king size bed. Look at it, it's huge! Isn't it huge? So, Denise, what's your favorite part about the Taj?
I like the little window seat that we've got going. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of time to just sit by the window. Lots of free time.
All right, let's have a look. Oh, we're in. We're in like Flynn. Hi, boys. Hello. What are you up to?
We got a bodyguard.
We're going to come and have a quick look in your crib, in your cabanes.
Always clean, but my girlfriend was just here and she messed.
So let me quickly introduce you. We've got Joe Hay, we've got Rye Hay. Hey, hey, hey.
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 Hey, hey. Hey, hey. Bling, bling.
So I'm just going to ask you a quick few questions. Guys, how long have you been living here in your cabanes? How long have you been living here, Ryan?
3 months.
Just 3 months? Do you love it?
I love it.
What's your favorite part about your crib?
It has to be Joe Ben and...
Let me just fix this up.
Where is he?
Okay. And our roommate.
Joe, hey, how long have you been here?
2 months.
2 months. And what's your favorite part about the cabanes, cribs?
My favorite part, I'll tell you my least favorite part.
Go on.
That you cannot easily fit two people on one bed.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
There's much more room. Mm-hmm. All I'm asking for.
Mm-hmm.
But we do have something we do for everyone who comes and visits.
What's that? Oh. Wow!
Just broke my elbow.
So thanks very much for showing us around your crib. Thanks very much, guys.
Yeah, no problem.
We'll see you later. Thanks very much. See ya. Bye, bye. So that was Joe Ben's and Ryan's cabanes, and I hope you've enjoyed these tours around these cabanes, and we'll hopefully see you soon.
Yes, hey man, you sure you don't want to buy some weed? They come with a bag of shit, you know what I mean? You're gonna need it, fuck. Sing song to jingle fucking bells, man, jingle fucking bells, and I know another one, rule off the fucking red nose reindeer.
Right. Thanks very much. Thanks very much, and we'll hopefully see you very soon here on Sovereign the Seas Cribs.
We have to party here because otherwise we'll be crazy. Yes, we'll be crazy because we just live here to work. That's why I think you have to relax, you have to drink, you have to party when you have free time. Even when you have to wake up early, sometimes you don't mind. No, at least I have some fun. I had some fun before.
Fun presented itself in many ways in the Sovereign. Back deck crew parties, for example. One of the most memorable parties was Halloween.
he was a sexy young lad that I met on the back of this deck. This is 2002 Halloween Party. We're going to give you an inside look of what's going on here at Royal Caribbean's crew party. Come on.
Sovereign of the Seas. I'm a massage therapist on board. Yeah, that's right. On board. We're going to go around. We're going to talk to some people, okay? Jace, how are you enjoying this Halloween party?
I'm having a fucking awful time.
Okay, next we're going to go to Kylie. Kylie. How are you doing tonight?
I'm fan-fantastic.
Fan-fantastic, you hear that? Okay, this is Kylie from the youth staff. Yeah, all right. Yeah, tell us how you're doing again.
Woo!
Exactly, that's all we can say about this.
The Demon Joker's pimp.
Yeah, and he is some hot stuff tonight. Look at this getup. Where do you find a costume like this?
In the back of my closet.
Happiness is just around the corner. Hey now, hey now. Hear what I say now. We'll be there for you.
Woo, it is getting freaky down here on back deck. Look at this. Look at this. Smile for the camera for us!
What's going on? What's going on here?
Right to the camera.
See?
Where's the camera?
I'm here with the tempting tiger, Laurie. Laurie, how are you doing this evening?
I am fantastic, David, but please let me tell you that I am a tigress and not a tiger.
Tigress, I'm sorry.
Have a penis.
Yes, tigress. How? Now, what made you decide to be a tigress this evening?
Well, David, it was a toss-up between the tavern wench and the tempting tigress. But when it came down to it, it was just a matter of fit of the costume.
Right, right. Well, I'll tell you what, you're very tempting.
Penis is just around the corner. Hey now, hey now. Hear what I say now. We'll be there for you. The Benga bus is coming and everybody's jumping. New York to San Francisco, an intercity disco. The wheels are still are turning and traffic lights are burning. So if you like to party, get on and move your body. The Benga bus is coming and everybody's jumping. New York to San Francisco, an intercity disco. The wheels are still are turning and traffic lights are
burning. Well, I'm here with some of the Steiner chicks. Here we go. Right. This here is Rashi. She is a mummy. A mummy like Cleopatra. Rashi, how are you doing?
I am doing so fine. I'm sorry I don't have my full attire on, but it was just really getting into my face. I'm having a great night. Everyone looks great. Everyone has just made the biggest effort, and it's been awesome. Go to Steiners!
Again, Emi Moore. You know I love you so much. And I always going to miss the time in the C-Shape Center, you know, on Sundays and Thursdays afternoon. I love you. Te quiero mucho.
So if you like to party, get on and move your body. The Bingo Bus is coming and everybody's jumping. New York to San Francisco, an intercity disco.
us on Wild on Sovereign of the Seas for Halloween 2002. This party is kicked. Everybody's gone to bed. We have stayed up to all hours of the night. Thank you for joining us. My name is Samantha, your port and shopping guide.
Exactly, and this is David from the salon massage therapist, kicking it from the last part of the party.
Good night.
The seas. There we go.
Good night, folks. Have a great night.
We were lucky in the crew staff, for the most part, in that we were all close and got along well. We'd look out for each other and help out. We enjoyed partying together, hanging out, and going places with each other. But most important of all, we were just plain silly. One of our jobs, which we shared with the youth staff, was working the gangway. This was the most repetitive and boring crew staff job on the ship.
8, that would be 4. And what is your stateroom?
We would greet the guests during boarding and make sure they knew where they were going. Through the double doors, take the elevators to deck 11 for lunch. Another job was the sail away party. While the ship was leaving port, we'd go up to the pool deck, get on the microphone, and teach some line dances to the guests. We'd also introduce ourselves and some of the other departments like the casino and housekeeping. It was fun, if we could muster the energy to do it. And what cruise would be complete without karaoke? There's also Coco Cay, Royal Caribbean's private island. There we did fitness walks and island greets. We'd also host volleyball tournaments, but in my opinion, the best job of all was the nighttime pool party, Dancing Under the Stars. Dancing Under the Stars, or DUTS for short, was similar to the sail away party in many ways. It was different in that there were a lot more people, most of them were drunk, and all of us were ready to party. During DUTS, we usually got drunk and had fun. Just one example of getting paid to party. The conclusion of each cruise docks the Sovereign in Port Canaveral, Florida. Crew members wait on the gangway for the windows to open. Windows are times U.S. Customs has allotted for crew to disembark the ship and serve as a form of drug traffic control. Once off the ship, crew go shopping, visit nearby family, or simply get some off-the-ship cuisine. Here for your Port Canaveral experience is Lori.
My name is Lori. I'm youth staff on board the Sovereign of the Seas and also Demi's neighbor. Lucky him. I just want to let you know that we had Boat Drill today, Coast Guard yearly event, which we passed, did wonderfully. I also want you to know that we're outside the terminal and everybody is wondering what the f*** we're doing on video camera. I just want to let you introduce you to a weekly process that we do here aboard the Sovereign. On every embark day, Sundays and Thursdays, it just happened to be, we get off of the ship if we're lucky enough, and we are allowed to get onto what we call the fun bus. Demi will get a shot of the fun bus momentarily. I just wanted to let you know that there is nothing fun about the fun bus. I have many stories to tell. I'm a bitter person about the fun bus. They charge us $6 a piece to get on there. They shove them in. They don't let you sit down. There is no chivalry. I've had men sit on my lap, large men, and I f***ing hate the fun bus. Okay, yeah, hi. I'm on the fun bus, and like I told you, there's nothing fun about it. I'm pissed off. We're like crammed in here like sardines. And it stinks. And they have the heat on in the bus. So anyway, we're off. What are you looking at? I'm joking, go to. We're off to Walmart and the mall. And now we're gonna stop up and pick more people up because we can't fit enough in here. Yeah, get the shot. He's gonna want us to move back. Yeah, there ain't no room.
What happened to the separating?
Yeah, and now they're picking up Disney people that have the Norwalk virus. Yeah. Hi. Gail, how are you enjoying the fun bus today?
It's not fun.
Austin, how are you enjoying the fun bus today?
It's not fun at all.
Fiona, how are you enjoying the fun bus today?
No, not at all.
Not fun.
Piotr, how are you enjoying the fun bus?
Not fun anymore.
See, it's just not fun. The consensus is this bitch bites. With Fiona, another USTAF member for the Sovereign. She's going to do her mailing today. We're in the mail room. As you can see, the mailboxes are behind us. This is the only way we get mail within 3 months of being here. As you can see, there's a long lineup, as there usually is. And we both have packages to pick up, so hopefully... but hopefully we get some good stuff. And then we share with the people in our hallway, right?
Always.
Once again, it's Lori from your USTAF here with Paul, our Viking Crown Lounge singer. Say hi, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
We're here at the Merritt Island Shopping Center, where it's just one of the two places we get dropped off when we're on the Sovereign of the Seas. How do you enjoy shopping at the Merritt Island Mall?
I love shopping here. I buy candy and cookies and books and CDs, and I have a great time.
Oh, wonderful. See, this is our little place where we hang out. We just finished having some lunch. Did you have lunch yet?
It was delicious.
No, you haven't had lunch yet, but it was delicious.
Yes, absolutely.
What's your favorite place? Where's your favorite place to shop here in Merritt Island Mall?
Well, I think I like Joe Mugg's coffee shop.
Do you?
Yeah, I go get coffee, you know, mocha lattes there. They're very good and good for you.
And good for you. You heard it here, folks. So, Dimmy, we're off to find some black outfits now for our Black Night. Paul, what are you buying?
I'm going to buy a black outfit, I'm pretty sure.
Are you? Yeah, we're going to go buy black outfits, and we'll catch you at Walmart. Timmy, I have to go to boat drill soon, so I'm going to skip out on Walmart. I'm going to go have a nap because, you know, it's all about napping upon the Sovereign. And why don't you just go on ahead without me? You know what Walmart's all about, you know, the carts, the white trash, the grocery, the booze. The booze in Walmart is good, though, because in Canada, you just don't get it there. And I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye, Dominiquois.
I feel like the time on a ship is—it's almost like you're in a time warp because you don't have you don't have weekends off, so you work every day of the week, and you don't have to be in bed at a certain hour because some days you might have to work at 10 o'clock in the morning, and other days you have to work at
5 o'clock or something. So some nights you go to bed at 9, some nights you go to bed at 2 in the morning. It's just, it's different all the time.
6 months, it's too long. 6 months for me looked like 1 year. 1 year.
Time away from home, family, and friends is a substantial strike against cruising careers. But one job perk that partially makes up for this is the beautiful ports of call. Coco Cay is Royal Caribbean's privately owned island. Guests board tender boats which transport them from the ship to the 3-quarter-mile-long island.
I love Coco Cay mostly just because it's beautiful. I had never been to the Bahamas before, the Caribbean or anything, so those pictures you see of the water being crystal clear, it really is.
Guests have plenty to look forward to in Coco Cay. There are the small shops filled with islandware and other trinkets. There's the curiously popular hair braiding service. And of course, the complimentary barbecue lunch.
The first time I came here, I loved Coco Cay. The color of the water, the nature there is really beautiful. But when you realize you are there every 3 and 4 days, it starts getting boring. Yes. You don't find the nature beautiful anymore and you just get bored. Oh, I have to work here all the time.
This is good. For those who are new to Coco Cay and not yet tired of it, there's plenty to do. Wave runners, kayaking, snorkeling. It's a water sport enthusiast's dreamland. Coco Cay is nice in that it is very relaxing, very peaceful. It has a certain atmosphere, and also great scenery. One island feature that surpasses any other, even the coma-inducing hammocks, is the beach. Coco Cay, we move on to our next port of call, the trashy yet beautiful Nassau, Bahamas.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, I'm Troy McClure. You might remember me from such pornographic films as Debbie Does, Nassau, and look, Demi's got a semi. I'm standing out here at Pier 20, where we have our mothership, our home away from home, Sovereign of the Seas. You see, we got Wasib from the Philippines, he's washing the windows, you'll check that out later. Next, on my right-hand side, we also have the Disney Wonder. Now today, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take you on a tour of Nassau. We're going to see you all the important sights of Nassau. Ladies and gentlemen, hold on tight, sit down, and shut the fuck up, because this is a tour you do not want to miss.
Security right here is checking everybody as they come in.
Go pants,
scooters, guys.
Hey, buddy, give me one of them. Come here, Rambo.
Do we look like tourists?
Come here.
Do we look like tourists to you?
Come here.
Sweet girl, come here.
Where do you go to? I want to speed.
Free?
No, no, I'm free.
in the Bahamas, baby.
So why are you putting this on me then?
Just leave a few bucks to have the kids then, maybe.
Hey?
A few bucks.
A few bucks? I don't have a few bucks on me.
Which one do you
want? Do you have a necklace like that?
Yeah.
Give me a necklace like that. I want a black one. Black like that. Necklace black. Come on. See, every time you're NASA, you get swamped by people just sell.
All right, yeah. Ain't no few bucks now. She keep the price.
A few bucks, right? She said a few bucks. You gotta wheel and deal them. You get the best deal.
You know? You can get between right now.
What do you got?
Not these.
A black necklace.
No. Black necklace like this on there?
Like this one right here. That one right there.
All right.
$2.
No.
How much?
$10.
$10. I can get a cheaper one somewhere else. Well, hey? Six? Five. $5. $6. I can do it with $6. For a beautiful Bohemian necklace, ladies and gentlemen, $6. Still have a deal. See, wheel and deal. They wanted $10, $6. So where you gotta go? All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Bay Street. This is NASA's main street where all the shopping centers are. We got the Jewelry Mart right there. Duty-free liquor, hard stuff, booze, which we like. Booze for your cruise. Look at that, too. Demi's going to show you Canadian bands. Canadian banks. There are Canadian banks in the Bahamas. Unreal. I can see myself with one of these on. How do I look? Don't let them fool you. Or even try to school you. Oh no. 9, 10, 10, 20, 13, 05. Thank you. Perfect. Always, always recount your money after they've given it to you. 1, 2, 3, 10. Always recount the money here. You never know. You never, ever know. I don't practice Santeria. I ain't got no crystal ball. I had $1 million, but I'd spend it all. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and this is welcome to the Internet Login Internet Cafe. This is where we come. The crew come here, we pay $5, we got an hour worth of internet. It's a lot cheaper than the one on the ship. We come here because it's cheaper and better computers. So this is a place where we hang out. When we come to Bahamas, we come here to email our family.
Nassau Royale liqueur made by Bacardi in the Bahamas.
Okay, give me try that. I want to try that out. I'm gonna try that.
Some good weed. We recommend some good weed.
Good stuff. I've never ever in my life been bothered so much with weed. Everybody's trying to sell me some ganja. Like, do I look like a tourist to you? Seriously? Here's to you. Here's to me. Here's to you, Demi, and to my friends at home. Thank you. Oh, that is good stuff.
What's that? What's the name of that?
Nassau Royale liqueur. Good stuff. Whoa, I feel drunk already, ladies and gentlemen. Very good stuff. All right. Sure. Coconut rum, ladies and gentlemen.
We are going to try some coconut rum. Look at him. It's not his first picnic.
Coconut.
Here's to you, Demi.
Wow. Just what the doctor ordered. Woo.
It's the best rum in the Bahamas, ladies and gentlemen.
Woo!
Merry Christmas.
Bohemian rum.
Bohemian rum, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! Yeah! All right! People know the body's playing.
Take a break. Ship life certainly is rough, ladies and gentlemen. I can't take it no more. I can't take it no more. I need another drink. Let's go back in there. I need another drink.
We're at Pirates Pub. $20 every Tuesday. Drink all you can. Drink all you can.
And we're still looking for someone that can drink all.
All you can drink for $20, man.
Sure.
Drink all you can. All right, check it out. These buses bring you all over Bahamas for $1 per ride, but you gotta be nuts to go into these buses. These drivers are maniacs. Look at him. Take a good shot at him. Wave for the camera, man. Wave for the camera. Right on. He's nuts. Nuts, I tell you. Hey guys, we're right outside the Straw Market. This place is huge. It's a 200 by 200 square feet, and there's like 2,000 little boutiques. Everybody is just jam-packed. They sell hats, pipes, shot glasses, t-shirts, you name it, they've got it in there. Sculptures, they're making it right there in front of you. It's unreal. It's like a zoo in there. But good deals, you get good deals. It's a good souvenir shop. It's the best souvenir shop in the Bahamas, actually. But it's expensive too. Everything here is expensive, but it's the price you gotta pay, you know what I'm saying? Over and out.
Not waiting for we got stopped by the police, Bohemian police, because we were videotaping McDonald's. Can't believe it. Yeah.
No, that's not that. Okay, yeah.
Okay, then it's right there.
All right.
Yeah.
Cool.
All right.
Did she know her?
She knows. She's got a name tag.
Like I said, just be careful what is what.
Hi, everybody. Here we are enjoying our free Big Mac, complimentary of the manager at McDonald's. We were stopped for false advertising, believe it or not. We were there shooting McDonald's, saying to all our friends that we have, no matter where we go around the world, we're always going to find a McDonald's. Security stopped us, asked us what we're doing. As a joke, we said we're advertising. They called the cops. The cops got involved. We had to erase our footage of McDonald's, but we're still going to give it another shot because we can still see it from here. Free food, but unreal. First time in it's our first sightseeing tour in the Bahamas, and we already got caught by the cops. We're on a roll, ladies and gentlemen. What can I say? Demi is speechless right now because his mouth is full, but he is enjoying his Big Mac. Over and out, ladies and gentlemen. Talk to you soon.
We grab a taxi and head across the Paradise Island Bridge toward one of the most popular destinations in Nassau, the Atlantis Hotel Resort.
Well, a very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are standing here in front of the beautiful statues of the Pegasus at the Atlantis Resort. We picked up a few dancers. So we have Abby here.
Hey.
And we have Melissa.
Hello.
And they wanted me to do a little
show for them, but I'm not going to do one because they're the professional dancers. Mind you, they don't use the pole. They used to use the poles, but they don't use the poles anymore.
No.
No, they just use the stage. No poles. No more poles.
Only when I'm drunk.
Only when they're drunk do they use the poles. All right, ladies and gentlemen, behind me is the Royal Suite of Atlantis. $25,000 per night to rent out this suite. You're required to rent it out for 3 nights minimum. Michael Jordan and Michael Jackson are a few of the famous, rich and famous, that have stayed there before regularly. Now, we're going to take you on some more sightseeing, so stick around. We'll show you some more stuff. Hey guys, we're just standing here by the Stinging Tourist statue, built in 1998. And behind me is the casino. This place is huge. We're not allowed to go in there because we're not allowed to bring cameras and videotape, so we're just gonna give you a brief overview of the casino. You can kind of see it behind me. And we just wanted to show you the image, the monstrosity of the casino. Hey, I'm standing in the backyard of Atlantis. Look at the general beauty of this place. We've got the suites again, $25,000 room. And just like the cute little waterfalls. We have stingrays all over there. This is a little pond where they have sharks and stingrays. And actually, this actually goes with the other aquariums. We're gonna go there too soon later. But this is just beautiful. It's a palace. It's an ancient, lost city.
Another dimension.
All right, this wraps up our tour of Atlantis. It's beach time!
Once we've had our fun in the sun and worked our butts off during the Nassau days, there's one most frequented club for our Bohemian nights.
The Boom! When I first came on ships, I did not think that I would go to a place like the Boom again. That's like a college bar where you can't walk around and everyone's so drunk and everyone's hitting on each other.
I like it because I think it's the only place that the crew can have fun outside the ship.
On Friday nights, once the crews and youth staffs were finished with dancing under the stars, we'd rush to our cabins for a quick cleanup. The ship left port at 3 a.m., and it was a written warning if we weren't back on board by 2:30.
Hi, this is Jovan from youth staff. We just finished doing Dutz, Dancing Under the Stars, and right now we're headed to Bahama Boom, our usual hangout spot on Friday nights. These are my drinking partners. Everyone actually that works on the ship is a drinking partner of mine, including the man behind the camera. And tonight we're going to play Where's Waldo, and I am Waldo, so come along.
All right. Bahama Boom. Boom shaker. Boom shaker ass. Boom shaker ass.
One more time.
Melissa. Melissa, are you having a good time tonight?
Yeah.
Is this pretty typical of your experience on the Boom?
This is very typical, but it's a lot more fun tonight.
What makes this particularly exciting? Is it us?
It's absolutely y'all.
You know, I'm just feeling celebration tonight. Celebrate. Don't wait too late. No.
We got the very beautiful, the very lovely Abby here. How is this compared to most of your experiences at the Boom?
One more time. One more time. One more time. A celebration. You know we're gonna do it right.
Here we have with us one of the male dancers, also my neighbor. Doug, how does this compare to most of your trips to the Boom?
I don't know him, but he knows me, obviously. And this is a fun time with the Boom. You guys, I love you guys.
We're gonna celebrate and dance so free. One more time, this got me feeling so free. We're gonna celebrate and dance so free. One more time, this got me feeling so free. We're gonna celebrate and dance. One more time. It's got me feeling so free. We're gonna celebrate, celebrate and dance so free. One more time. It's got me feeling so free. We're gonna celebrate, celebrate and dance so free. One more time. It's got me feeling so free. We're gonna celebrate, celebrate and dance so free. One more time. It's got me feeling so free.
Turn back on shit.
One more time, it's got me feeling so free. We're gonna celebrate, celebrate and dance so free. One more time, it's got me feeling so free.
It's been another great Waldo adventure.
Yeah, for the boom! And Ben's first time.
And Ben's first time at the boom?
Oh,
it was. How was it for
you?
It was beautiful, beautiful.
What was your favorite part about the boom?
Kylie.
Me?
Of course. See you lovebirds later. It's been another Waldo adventure. Thanks for coming along. This is how it is, a typical night of the boom. A little crazy, a little fun, but now we gotta run back to our ship. We made it with 4.5 minutes to spare.
No.
Perfect! Another Waldo adventure executed to perfection.
Back deck! Let's go! That was not a
I'm drinking the hard stuff tonight.
What the? 30. I'm first,
Biatch! Wait, what's tomorrow? Wait, I'm getting massage.
I pray we go.
We have to.
I pray we go.
Look at me!
Okay.
What happens at 4:45?
Monday.
4:45. Lisa gets a massage.
Oh, massage.
I'll be there.
She'll be there. 4:45.
I'm Waldo, the chef. You want to lick my shoulders on the balls? If you want to quick pick me up, put my balls in your mouth.
I didn't rhyme.
Ah, suck on my chocolate, salty balls. Put it in my mouth and suck up.
Save the whales.
I always had work hanging over my shoulders. I always had a ton of stuff to do. And my life was just so structured. I was unhappy. And this is great because you meet people from all over the world, which is awesome. And I love living on the water. I love looking out at the water and seeing the waves. And it's just always beautiful. And being in the Caribbean where it's always warm. So it's just so much more relaxed than the real world. This isn't the real world for me. It's my escape from reality.
A reality that follows you to ships is that you're away from home for the holidays. Having family on board cheers the spirit.
Say Hail Mary.
Thank you.
Thank you and thank you and thank you and thank you. Merry Christmas.
You know what I ought to do? I get everybody to do the wave.
Alyssa.
Look at Melissa.
Hi,
Debbie. Here, first you cut the paper, then you wrap it in the bag.
What song you made?
There's a big clear version.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, how many more pieces?
Here you go.
You know I'm great.
It's strange that the best and worst part of working on a cruise ship is the friends you make there. They bring you joy, but everything must change. And therein lies the trouble.
Making friends on a ship is awesome because they are from all over and you learn so many different things. And it's so nice. You never feel alone. Like if you're having a bad day or something bad happens, you can just go down the hall, two doors down, and knock and talk to a friend. Whereas, you know, in the real world, you live by yourself. If you're having a bad day, you don't always have somebody to go to.
After my pictures fade and darkness has turned away, watching through windows, you're wondering if I'm okay.
I think ship's life is nice to meet people. Especially here, you meet people from different places, from different countries, and it's nice. But the sad thing is you realize that you will never see these people again. It's really sad.
At least we live in a world where with technology and email and people can travel so much easier now that there are chances that you'll get to see them again. So it's never actually goodbye. It's more see you later.
Everybody, I hope you enjoy my little show here, and I hope that now you have a better idea of what cruise ship life is all about. I certainly hope to see all of you sometime in the future. Please enjoy your lives, enjoy yourselves, and have a great time. Just remember, don't go overboard. See you around.
All right, behind us, ladies and gentlemen, is the Royal Suite of Atlantis. Take two. Ladies and gentlemen, behind us is the Royal Suite of Atlantis. $25,000 per night. You're required to stay there a minimum of 3 nights. Celebrities such as Michael Jackson and Michael Jordan stay there regularly. Regularly. God, yes. Take five.
Sometime later, I'll see you up in the Viking Crown Lounge. Oh, look, there's Jeremy showing one of his best assets, his only asset.
I mean, what happened to chivalry? And then you pay your $6 and you get on. Can I answer the door?
Yes, Port Canaveral. Port Canaveral and the fun bus.
It's a shit. It's a shit. Sometimes I don't even want to go outside.
Get. No! Oh, scared me! What are you doing?
Famous people like Michael Jackson and Michael Jordan stay there regularly.
You're like, we're standing here.
Yeah. Okay. Laugh it up. Come on, you do it then.
One more time.
Yes.
The staff mess. What a sight to behold. There's fruit over there. Not that guy. I don't think he's a fruit.
So give us a rap song here, John.
All right. The name is John. I got it going on. I rap from night until dawn. All right? The song is not long, so I'm gone.
I don't need a drink to have a good time. No!
Yes, it is.
I don't need a drink to have a good time.
I don't need a drink to have a good time.
I don't need a drink to time. I don't need a drink to have a good time. I don't need a drink to have a good time.
The chef says, not only is it all about the Demi, it's about Demi's semi. Now I'm playing. Demi's semi, chocolate, salty malt. It goes together. Figure it out. Get back.
Well, can I have another beer?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Behind me is the Royal Suite of Atlantis. $25,000. All right, hello.
Dude, we got dinner in the Windjammer tonight. So meet outside.
Yeah. That's fucking brilliant.
Dude. We got dinner in the Windjammer tonight.
No, I got some more work to do.
And at night, somebody's coming around the corner. They don't know you're here. So if you bring a loved one up here, let me tell you something. I can't think of what to sell you, but it's something.
And Lori and company have been to Breezes, so they're already ready.
So we already had a full day of drinking. I think I have wet boobs. So yes, I do.
Are we gonna sign it?
Yes.
Are we all gonna sign it?
We're all gonna sign it.
Look at Bethany. Woo! I just want to let you know, I have no underwears on right now. I put my towel on at Breezes, and I took off my wet bathing suit, and I put on my jazz shorts. So I am so panties right now. And Steph, who's French, will know that songs means none.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Behind me is the Royal Suite of Atlantis.
Ship electrician right here. He's the man that gives us all our power. He's the man with the power. Are you the man with the power?
I think I have the power also.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Lynn and I'm the host of Some Boy. And I'm the first piece of chocolate Demi has ever tasted. I also would like to say that's why you don't see me on the videotape, because sometimes he gets shy and embarrassed.
Are you still drinking your wine?
Wait, I'm not done. I'm making my debut now because I don't know when you'll see me on this videotape again, country people. To let you know, let it be known, I am the only piece of chocolate Demi has ever had. Merry Christmas.
And I'd like to put on the record that I'm the only piece of white chocolate Demi has ever had. Woo!